friends, my name is Ksenia and we are learning Russian. Today let's start learning prepositions. In your comments you often asked me to make a lesson on prepositions, so okay, let's do it. Today is the first lesson. We will do it one preposition a lesson and then we will see, maybe we change something. Let's start. The first preposition that we learn today is na, which means on. Na. We talk about a location of something. On the table. На столе. When we talk about prepositions, we have to talk about cases of nouns. I plan to make lessons on cases of nouns later, but today we can't escape at least mentioning this subject because we will learn prepositions together with nouns. Preposition на, on, is more often used with nouns in a prepositional case. Russian nouns, as well as Russian verbs, change their arrangements in different cases. Yes. Noun table, stol, на столе. Infinitive stol. Oh, sorry, not infinitive. Nominative case stol. Prepositional case на столе. Ending is changed. In prepositional case, nouns the most often get ending е, стол, столе, but sometimes е. You will see today from our examples. Стол на столе, стул, chair, на стуле. Стол на столе, стул на стуле. Prepositional case. Preposition on, на. Now let's take some other examples with preposition на. I will read, not to forget something. We already know. On a table на столе, on a chair на стуле, on a bed на кровати. For example, a pillow is on a bed. На кровати. Nominative case кровать. Prepositional case на кровати. In this case, you see, we get ending и, кровати, not е. Кровати, на кровати. On the ground, на земле. Земля, на земле. On the paper, на бумаге. Paper, бумага, на бумаге. Ending е. On the door, a number, for example, a number for the office is on the door. На двери, дверь, на двери. On a tree, bird maybe, bird on a tree. На дереве, дерево, на дереве. On the skin, a tattoo. На коже, кожа, the skin, на коже. Now let's take some cases which tells not about the position or location of the thing, but have some other meaning. On a diet, I am on a diet. In fact, I'm not on a diet. На диете, diet, диета, на диете. Я на диете. On the lesson. На уроке. Урок, lesson, урок, на уроке. For example, our teacher explained this on the lesson. Учитель объяснил это на уроке. I will repeat it again. On a table, на столе. On a chair, на стуле. on a bed, на кровати, on the ground, на земле, on the paper, на бумаге, on the door, на двери, also ending e, дверь на двери, on a tree, на дереве, on the skin, на коже, on a diet, на диете, on the lesson, на уроке. Now let's stick to our good tradition to have training in the end of the lesson. I say noun in nominative case and you say it in prepositional case with preposition на, on, на. I say стол, you say на столе. I say stool, you say на стуле, okay? Let's start. And I will help you after some time. Стол, you say на столе. Стул, на стуле. Кровать, на кровати. Земля, на земле. Бумага, на бумаге. Дверь, на двери. Дерево, на дереве. Кожа, на коже. Диета, на диете. Урок, на уроке. Окей, good. Now let's take it a little bit more difficult. I say in English, you say in Russian. I say on the table, you say на столе, okay? On the table, you say in Russian. На столе. On the chair. На стуле. On a bed. На кровати. On the ground. На земле. On the paper. На бумаге. On the door or on the door. На двери. On a tree. На дереве. On the skin. На коже. On a diet. На диете. On a lesson. On the lesson. На уроке. Молодец. It is enough for today. I hope I will record lessons on other prepositions. We as well have lessons on Russian verbs. If you see my video for the first time, then follow our YouTube channel, join our Facebook page. See you in my next lessons. Let's learn Russian and make friends. Давайте учить русский и дружить. Пока!